housing affordability debate between baby boomers and millennials has been reignited.
In an opinion piece written by Bernard Salt, the demographer listed reasons why young people can't afford a property. Now, this included splashing their cash on pricey breakfasts, paying $22 or more for smashed avocado on toast at, quote, hipster cafes.
But Gen Ys have hit back, saying the great Aussie dream of owning a home has become so out of reach that they'd rather enjoy life's simple indulgences. So, is property ownership out of reach for Gen Y because of high prices or high-priced breakfast choices? Demographers Bernard Salt and McCrindle join us now to debate this issue. Guys, welcome. Bernard, let's start with you. You kicked off this whole debate with your opinion piece. It has made international headlines. Did you expect a reaction as big as this?
No, in fact, when I wrote the piece, I wrote it as an amusing observation of what happens when a 50-something wanders into a hipster cafe. And most of the article was actually about quite parodying and being quite satirical about the middle-aged process. You can't read the menus, you can't sit on a milk crate, you can't work out the male and female toilets. And in any respect, it was around middle age decline, in fact. And then I made the point that what goes through the minds of a 50-something in one of these cafes, they dare not say this out loud because it would cause a great commotion. I said what goes through their minds is that we think there's so many young people in this cafe, how can they afford it? Shouldn't they be saving for a house? Not that we actually dare say that out loud. And that was the amusing element of it. But then on Monday, just five or six lines from the column made it onto social media. And of course, all hell has broken loose. So if you've seen this on social media, then could I suggest that you read the entire column to see the context of what I was saying?
Yes, indeed. You've stirred the pot, Bernard, but I agree with you on many fronts. Mr. Mark McCrindle, you do not agree. What is your point?
No, I think Bernard makes a very good point. And maybe it's because I'm a Gen Xer, I sort of can see, you know, the baby boomer perspective. They worked hard, they earned what they have. But I can also see the Gen Y perspective. The reality is it is a lot more expensive to buy a home. Costs of living are up. Gen Ys do have to pay off the debt on their degree. They didn't get them free. And there are new categories of spend. Technology, internet, mobile phone. When you're starting out in life that their parents didn't have. So certainly there are new costs, higher costs that they have to bear.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Now, Bernard, you're saying if Gen Ys spend $44 on smashed avocado every weekend, well, that would equate to $2,100 a year. Now, would that even make, do you think, a significant dent if you're saving for a home deposit?
No, in fact, there's been some wonderfully creative bits of social media saying that I've stopped eating smashed avocado and now I own a castle. I suppose the point that I was making was that this was a metaphor, in fact. But I also agree with Mark that the cost of housing has transitioned over 30 years. Sydney in particular is now a global city. And the issue is that Generation Y, I think, has become disheartened because they see the price of property so high that they make other choices. I will also say, though, that I think that Generation X and Generation Y are stepping away from home ownership, even if housing was affordable. I don't think Generation Y would want to commit to a 30-year mortgage holding them in a city for that length of time. They see their lives and lifestyles as being far more fluid, far more flexible than preceding generations.
I kind of disagree. I think they would love to own something. I think they just feel exactly like a few people have said to you on social media, it's just too hard, it's too far out of their reach. Mark, if we look at the median unit prices in capital cities, if you look at the average household income, it's $113,000 a year. And now you have a look at kind of the median unit prices around the country we've got up on the screen there. Is the Aussie dream out of reach?
It's increasingly out of reach, and these are just unit prices, of course. If we bring the Aussie dream of a home into the equation, it really blows it out, more than $1 million average in Sydney. That's the challenge, and it is disheartening for young people, because if they feel they can't get the deposit and they can't get into home ownership, it's a negative spiral, because then they end up spending that money on various pursuits, on lifestyles, on depreciating assets, entertainment and intangibles. always what has been the case in Australia is that the forced savings of a home and paying off that deposit, paying off the mortgage, actually creates wealth. And if you don't have the forced deposit payment, that then means you end up further behind the economic eight ball.
Yeah, sure. Bernard, Federal Treasury boss John Fraser has expressed how hard it is to buy a home, saying that young Aussies were being forced to rely on the bank of mum and dad when buying their first home. This was also echoed by the Prime Minister a couple of weeks ago in an interview with John Fain, and he said, "I'd prefer to call it intergenerational equity." What do you say to that?
Well, in fact, I agree that I think that baby boomer parents should help where they can, but I also understand that not all Generation Y have parents that are in that situation. I think that as a society, we work better as Australians when everyone believes they have access to the property market, if that's what they want.
Yeah, so right, guys. Thank you. We are out of time. Lovely to debate this issue. Thanks a lot.
My pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you.